Okay, test 1 2 1 2. All right, looks like we're working. I think everything's up. Let's start doing this. Actually, I'll give it a couple minutes. Let's do this. Red. Yes. Pain, joy, life, fun, disgust, worthlessness, love, death. The creature catches me off guard and kills me. The end. God, I thought this game was actually longer than that. I'm really losing my touch. Skeleton, actually. I buy you become only what I've ever seen in biology books. A skeleton. Hey, Izzy. Oh, this is the most awkward meeting ever. How'd you two meet? Well, I but spy snatcher. Get on the good side of the person whose body you just stole and turn into a skeleton after attacking them. I am not a name, I am a number. Next. I'll just go stock. I'll go stock one. It should be familiar. After all, it is a number. If you're saying we didn't get a broadcast, and I'm currently streaming this, which technically could be considered a broadcast, does that mean it's not a broadcast, or it is a broadcast, or it's broadcastception? So now at this point, you are sharing a body. Your body. Now, even though it's considered an ARPG, and even though there's story involved, I kind of feel the story is just kind of all over the place, and not really one to take seriously at all. Like, your personal backstory, the fact you're a silent protagonist, it's just kind of like, whatever. Like I said, I kind of like just smile and nod at it. Okay, now we're talking about soulmates. Wait, what? Did we just go How does this work in the body snatching world? I mean, is first base when you body snatch somebody and then you hit a home run when you call him a soulmate, or what? I'm so confused. So anyway, this is actually only Japanese voices, so there's no option to change that into English. Which is fine. You're still possessing the cast, yeah. Or maybe like Persona does it. And here we go, here's our first chance to shoot stuff. I am shooting you! And that's how you do it. So, you basically shoot enemies and have stuff happen. That's kind of one of the premises of this game. One of your goals is to shoot monsters, the other goal is to purge poison, which we haven't seen yet. Here it is right now. Cleansing Myers, which is the poison. So, you purge, like so. In this case, you don't need to pay attention to the enemies, they'll just disappear once you're done. The poison, on the other hand, won't. And if you stand in the poison, you're gonna get hurt. Unless you summon her to do it. Shooting boxes and purging poison also can unearth items, which can be useful. And that's kind of just a basic thing. It's pretty easy to learn and pick up, which is one reason I actually enjoy it. And if you're lucky and get an enemy caught in there, you can do massive damage. Hey, Big! You're gone.
初めてのニシン一体だけど、なんとかなったみたいだね。そう、ニシン一体っていうのは、体が一個で魂が二個の状態のこと。
Two souls who share the same body. I must point out this was not consensual at all on my end. I never asked to suddenly turn to a skeleton.
私みたいな亡者と君みたいな生の体、聖者が一つになることなの。さっきみたいに君と私どちらかの体の中にこれ、なんでしかもなんかサイズ感やばくない？
When did I get huge? Huh? Not quite how it works, but whatever.
なんじゃこりゃっていうか、君のその腕。
Yes, I now have the ability to turn to Samus Aran or something.
そっか。私がちっちゃいのは君の腕一本分の。
And then an odd jingle rings from the old radio strapped to your waist. What?You'll be hearing these two every time you do a mission. And frankly, I really enjoy their conversations. I think they're actually pretty hysterical together. So, what can I tell you about Poison Control? Well, it's a relatively short game. It's about 15 to 20 hours long. There is a true ending and a standard ending. And...The game basically is an ARPG. Oh, here these two again. And every level is called the Bell's Hell because it's a mortal girl who either is going to hell or is in hell. So, kind of like Persona 5, as Izzy knows, with people who have grand delusions. It's kind of the same premise.So each of these levels is sort of like a small story wrapped in one about the person you're trying to rescue. So they'll review how someone fell to hell, why, and as you do it, you start to learn more about what happened. So it's actually kind of cool. But because of this, because those stories can be pretty interesting,The overarching story itself isn't so interesting. It kind of lacks the cohesion needed. I must erase everything. I must kill every last one of them. Oh, wait. It's exactly the same case, Izzy. These are all, like, very fucked up desires. Well, some are fucked up, some are not, but...So this one starts out just standard school, apparently. Just another fine day in Makai, yes.Purge the poison until next time, damn us all to hell! No, I've tuned into Jet Set Radio before, does that count?
あの電波塔が毒沼の発生を伝えてくれてるの。
Yes, this is Makai, as Izzy eloquently called it.
ここ のんびり話してる場合じゃなく2回も死ぬなんて絶対嫌だ地獄の浄化始めるよ
Okay, so this is a standard level, the first level. It usually comes with two objects. One is either maybe a total purge, maybe you have to collect stuff, maybe you have to kill enemies. Various things. There are very small levels. The longest one will take like 30. So, generally speaking, you could blitz through a few of these at a time. Yep, that's the poison right there. You go into purge mode and you have to wipe out the poison. Now, our overarching goal is 85% purge the entire place, so we have to do that. If you get an enemy caught in there, you can kill them outright. Sometimes, even though it's an RPG, and even though you have the ability to shoot enemies, sometimes you can't. Sometimes it's not worth it. So you gotta sort of prioritize what you want to do, and that's part of the strategy involved. So yeah, you can shoot enemies, but there are rooms where they'll regenerate non-stop, so... Like, in this case, that guy regenerates, so just shooting them outright usually isn't worth it. Now you can sort of see as we're taking care of the poison that there's little details there, like little sheets of paper in this case, because of someone needing an eraser at school. Well, little things like that. Now, some things like maybe like Japanese newspapers or whatever, things like that. So there's a little personality here. I think the best part of the game really is is kind of the atmosphere it generates. And even the color palette, I think, is really good. They do a pretty good job at that. Little hint right there that, hey, something's really messed up because there's actually charred letters. Now, I move in a circle because if you do that, you can actually get all the encompassing poison there. You don't necessarily need to do that, though. You just run in a straight line. Anything that she runs over can be taken that way, and sometimes that is useful. So, something like this, for example, does work, but you'll do a far better job if you simply do this. There's boxes right here, so let's take care of them. These stages do encourage exploration, so you're going to want to do that. As you see, because sometimes you might get goodies, you might get hidden treasures like this. Now this right here is a poison gem. If you collect 3 of them, you get a new weapon. They're not very difficult to find, so I would definitely encourage you to do that. You're not going to have too much difficulty for the most part. As long as you're thorough in your exploration, you should be fine. And they can be very useful. Because as it stands right now, we only have one weapon. This toxicant poison net, as you see. This is your basic pea shooter, and will become thoroughly outclassed later on in the game. So, needless to say, not good. So, we have a toxicant. This is our basic weapon, as I mentioned. Once you run out, you can reload. It takes a little time, but that's that. But, for all intents and purposes, because you have infinite reloads, you have infinite ammo. However, these deliriants right here are limited ammo. They're usually much more powerful, but I only have 18 shots, and after that, I ain't using it until I pick up more deliriant ammo. So, 90% of the time, you're probably going to be using your toxicants, because that's kind of the primary weapon you have. Anyway, we have this thought form right here. These are So these are memories. These are how you learn more about the people in question who you're trying to save. And you can see what makes them screwed up and what's wrong with them and what you can do. It's kind of like eavesdropping, but not really. I can't tell. So, as you see, the person in question has to hide something for whatever reason. Burn. So the eraser isn't an eraser, it's more like a lighter. That's, disturbing. Now, being the first stage, obviously the story is very basic. Later on, it'll get a little more complex, so. You do want to be careful when you're doing this, because enemies will try homing on you. And if they hit you or poison at the person who's moving around, you could get hurt. And especially when you're doing this, as you see the skeletons right there, you're kind of a sitting duck. So if an enemy is charging at you and hits you, it does damage. Yes, Izzy, burn her to the ground. And we got another poison gem. Oh, a special shooting enemy. Well, you don't want to get hit by the projectile as her or as yourself, so you need to be definitely careful of that. Defeat 3 Kleshes, so now the Poison Mire doesn't matter, and unfortunately I'm out of ammo, so I gotta go to the Delirium. You really don't notice the leveling up, but because it happens so easily. Getting experience happens so fast. Pretty much anything you do. Kill an enemy, kill a Klesha, experience. Purge a poison, listen to a thought form, all works. One issue I have with this game, one of the biggest issues I think, but it's not as pervasive as it seems, oddly enough. You notice I have 6 shots left on what is actually 10 shots. A 10-shot clip. You cannot reload in this game. The only way to reload is to spend your clip inexplicably. You'd think it'd be a huge inconvenience, but the reality is it's not as inconvenient as it seems, especially later on where you can equip more weapons at a time. But for right now, it may be a little bit of a pain in the neck. Immortal, you don't see those every day. Hell savvy soul, kind of just like a random person who gives you advice. Look at that. If I take care of that innocuous looking Mire over there, I got my 3rd gem. So now, when I'm done with the stage, I'll actually get a new weapon. This is how you get the good shit. Oh, he got me. But I should be okay because I got 85 out of 85. But you know what? I feel like being a douche. Might as well explore as much as I can, because you never know. You might unearth more money. Usually it's money I'm going after when I do this. But...
Oh,
Also, as you see, there's a little timer there every time I switch out. That's the game's way of keeping you in check. So if you bring the girl out on a random, on a very long journey, you might not be able to get as much poison as you want. But anyway, this is our final treasure right here. It's a soul shard. This is kind of the ultimate item you're looking for. The goal. In this case, it's a lighter. And now you're going to get the back end, the more of the story. I have to erase it. All of it. Oh, jeez. As you see, fucked up. Really? Yep. And there you go. And now we have a heart to heart. Yep. So. Like I said, Izzy, these people can be very, very fucked up. That's why they're like Desires, because the people in Persona 5 Strikers you've seen are psychopaths too. So you see the next skills there, and you see this. So as I level these up, Synergy, Empathy, Insight, Toxicity, and Trust, I'll actually get better skills. It only shows you the next few, but I don't think there really is a reason to max min in this case. And as you see from these three right here, if I pick this one, my empathy goes up, this one, my trust goes up, and this one, my toxicity goes up either. So, I would say the key right here, I'll just pick whatever one. Once I level up Empathy at level 2, as you see, I'll actually get more HP healed every time I do a purge successfully. And since purging happens a shit ton, that's a very good thing. In this game, there's two ways to heal yourself. Well, three ways, technically. One way is if you use a recovery when you run out of HP. But outside of that, randomly finding HP pickups and purging mire. Those are the two ways to do it. And the poison mire we covered earlier has been purged. Yes. A special giveaway prize, which all basically is just basically a badge of honor. It might be, it could be, it's... There's no reward. What? It's a delivery klesha. That's who's giving you the reward. Don't ask how. This klesha right here is basically domesticated enough to do this, since everyone you see is basically 100% feral. A clutch just stands silently beside us, a blank look plastered on what I imagine to be its face. Yep. So it just gives you a sticker. Maybe I mentioned, but it sounded like someone was just talking shit. Yes. Oh, it's a radio show in hell. I'm sure they can say shit just fine. Oh, you gotta call it bullshit instead. And there you go. That's the first stage. Collect 5, and you get yourself a ticket to heaven. Wait, what? So this is kind of, I guess, sort of like the goal here for her is she wants to get into heaven for some reason. Because you get wishes granted. Why do I feel like this offer is kind of got strings attached? Okay, Synergy. Synergy will give me more speed if I get to level 3. I'm gonna go with this one. I'll get Insight. Looks like I picked a pretty good choice. The amnesiac trope, everybody. Except this time, we're actually two souls sharing... Two amnesiacs sharing a soul. Well, maybe not, because I do know the name. Yep, there we go. So it's now basically you and Poisonette trying to save Hells and stuff. So, before we go anywhere, the game doesn't do this for the tutorial, oddly enough. You have to figure this out for yourself. Whenever you get a new thing, a new, the 3 poison gems and a new weapon, you always want to go here. So you can equip and stuff like that, and also upgrade if need be. I can't upgrade anything now, but you get the idea. As you see, that 3 gem, the 3 gems you got here has turned into this for Ayumi Mori. As you see, if I equip this, now I have increased defense. So, not bad. The poison mire resistance, honestly, is not that big a deal as a perk, so I probably can get rid of this at some point, but it's better than nothing. And you can save anytime you're here on the overworld, so. So let's go to the next chapter, the next stage. The Bell Bound by Death. But first, another trip at Higan Radio.
Ah,
走るの辛いなら私が体になるけどダメチッケチ。
So here we go with our first real stage. And yes, I know the load bar does this every single time, but it actually does load. This one right here doesn't present itself like a psychopathic story like the other one did. All the hell, yes.
死んじゃったこの少女地獄か。ちょっと厄介そうだね。
Alright. Difficulty in this game, as far as it goes, I will say is not particularly difficult. You do take quite a bit of damage every time you get hit, so there is that, but it can be mitigated with the right equipment.
お便りでは、まあ、どこ、何?死んだ子に対して冷たんだってここあの世だしそんな話は今更って感じだし先に伝えとくけど私はそういう愛とか情とかというわけでおしゃべりもあとね毒沼掃除に行くよ。
As you see there's also a time limit right near the, where the map is. The time limit never comes into never factors in ever. You have to get lost or likeGo away for like an hour in order to lose. As far as taking damage goes, you see three butterflies to where my HP is. Basically, they're three extra lives. Or three revivals. And look at that, by destroying the three boxes, I got my first poison gem. So, that's something to consider. Let's see. Like I said, so in terms of difficulty, not overly difficult.Later on, you might come across a stage that could be, or two that might be punishing, but other than that, not too bad. I think I got like one game over and I got myself out of it. I was only stuck, I would say, in like one spot ever. But, you know, it's one of those cases, once you get good, nothing really matters. And that's kind of what happened to me.Oh look, we have a newspaper here. I can't read Japanese, so whatever. Memory of the incident. Earlier this morning, a body was found collapsed and bleeding on a city street. The victim, a young girl, is believed to be Mahoro Hiragi, a student at nearby public school.75% of the mire. When you take out half an enemy's HP, you break them, which basically is a stun. A temporary stun, so. Definitely helps you out to buy time at the very least. But like I said, I would only worry about that if I'm actually trying to attack enemies. And you get a picture right here of two girls walking hand in hand for whatever reason. The bell's thought form, as always, is the person whose hell you're in. So any other thought form is just another person. You have a writer and an artist. Well, a sickly artist and a writer. And we leveled up again. 70% of the mire. Okay. Now, even though it seems like we're doing nothing but mires right now, as you've seen previously, you get challenges for defeating enemies, among other things, so obviously, this being an early stage, that's kind of why it is the way it is. Also, one little issue this game I noticed. Let's say you're purging Myers, and let's say you just finished. Okay, you got to 81% out of 70, or whatever. If an enemy's... There's a split second there where before you're done, in between when you're done and when the thing shows up saying you completed it. You can get hit in that time gap, and I've had it happen to me, and it's infuriating every single time. So you do want to be wary and dodge if need be. Knock your health bar in half, and they fall on their butts. Yep. And if you purge them, you can knock them down that way too. So there are two ways to stun them, basically. Anytime you hear that little giggle or whatever it sound, that always means that an enemy's coming. So anytime you do that, it means that somebody's coming. Oh, that looks like blood. That ain't good. It's done. I finished it. I think you're starting to see what happened. And she was never heard from again. Alright, defeat a clutch, but we need to find out what the one that says target on it. If there is one. Here you go. Okay, this is a bigger Klesha. Bigger Kleshas actually have glowy parts on them that are kind of like weaknesses that do extra damage. You don't need to hit them. It does help though. And you're stuck inside a mire. And there you go, done. Have drawn picture book.
Nani?
Yep, I already know how this ends.
I never so touched anything in all my life.
There's cores and radio gauge filter, okay.
Okay, the bell soul is how you end this, but we're not going to do that because I got to search for the other gems.
I have a feeling I know where the others are, but
there's one over there, so.
Ow, jackass.
You hit me.
Oh, hello. Okay, I got a special attack. I'm gonna use it right now because I need you. And as you see, I lost all my health and used up one of my recoveries. But I did significant damage to this guy, so. So I used a special attack there. The soul purge. Pain in the ass to use because it does have a small like charge up time, I guess. But once you get it, it does pretty good damage and knocks enemies on their butts. Will the butterfly come back? Yes, over time. You just need to, you know, keep doing what you're doing. But more importantly, we got all the poison gems, so now let's get out of here. I love how I mentioned difficulty and I end up having to use a recovery in that stage. It is what it is. Like I said, enemies hit very hard, so that's something you gotta get used to for a little bit. There is something you can get later on that can really help you, but it takes a while to build. Just like you play your gacha games. Damn it, gachas. Oh yes, gacha hell, I can definitely relate to that. I've seen it in full force, but I still don't spend money on it, thankfully. Besides, I pulled a super, super rare a while ago. Uh-huh. Yeah, I know that feeling. I actually pulled a super, super rare. I actually have one where the most common thing you can get is a rare. And then there's a super rare, and then there's an extremely rare. That's how they get you. There's no such thing as a common anymore. Well, I don't have Genshin, dude.
ないでびっくりしちゃったけど、今度は驚かない。見つけたわ、この泥棒猫。
Busted you dirty home wrecker. What? A girl dressed in formal black attire as if in mourning. And then her. Wait, you're just called yourself a homewrecker. What? Don't press prestige. What? I think you mean noblesse oblige. There's gotta be a way to use that somewhere. Don't press prestige. It's noblesse oblige. You can say, well, no, you can't. Capping off the ridiculous banter, expect that every single time. She butchers his phrases like crazy. The girl gives me a thorough look over his skin from head to toe. And then... Of course you would, Izzy. And then, HAG! Also ass. No breast prestige, but definitely ass prestige. Suddenly, HAG! And then she has then she calls you a homewrecker. I'm pretty sure Poison would be screaming that right now. You homewrecker! And if I say homewrecker one more time, I'm gonna... I knew you'd see that, Izzy. If I say homewrecker one more time, I'm gonna start thinking of Love Tyrant again. So that's how we became adversaries. Over a hug. Which, once again, I never asked for this. Okay. I know you want to say this. It turns out to be a pretty good answer because how far it went up. Be seeing those two again because there is that rivalry thing now going, but once again, very little to take seriously. After all, the banter kind of said everything. When the very first thing you see is no breast prestige or no blessed oblige, what do you expect? And Alright, on to the next one. Oh, wait. Now we got a new toxicant. Now I can put this here. So this is a rapid fire piece here, not very powerful. But now, whenever I run out of one, I can switch to the other just like that and be okay. So as you see, I have now enough money to upgrade something, so I might as well. Like I said, poison it is kind of just a regular pea shooter, not really worth it in the long run. And this one isn't really worth it in the long run either. Nothing really is worth it in the long run at this point, but still. But we could charge one up, why not? It ups your damage, ups your clip size, and as you get higher and higher ranks, you can unlock skills like charge shots, higher fire rates, things like that. Oh god, the mascot crazy old bell. The hell of a bell and a fair mascot. Mascots are love, mascots are life. Now, this is where I point out that this is an NIS game. What is their mascot? Printies, dude. So why did I bring that up? Because printy rule number one. Oh, but first, a butchering. A scene straight from hell, except we're in hell. We have broken remnants on arm, leg, and have a collection.
ここ地獄だし、もしかして私の声聞こえちゃった？二神一体って隠してる気持ちが聞こえない？ね、別に怖いわけじゃないけど、不意打ち、人肌感じたいっていうか。
Hey, means the player is doing a Souls game, ain't that the truth? Anyway, on to the mascots. Pretty rule number one, you shall always include the word dude in every line you say. Pidrin, I love you! You're probably a sculpted figure, your melancholy existence, your subservient veneration. What? Take me away, mascot. What? It's not Pinrin at all. So we have a girl here who's completely obsessed with a mascot. This is like Santa Claus now. So what exactly is a Pinrin, guys? You probably know already, but that might give it away.
Yep.
Alright. So, Prinnies. Or Pinrins. As you see, the Pinrins look a lot like Prinnies. And if you take Pinrin, you'll notice that it is an anagram of Prinny. Further reinforcing the fact that we are talking about Prinnies here. And now we have Klesha. And they say dude and dudettes. Pinny, Pinny, Pinrin. Dudette. Oh, God. That's one down. Pimp your pretty playa, dude. Court adjourned, dude. Yep, and this is where you learn you gotta take out real cough cough, real Pinrin Kleshas. Not fake ass ones. Whatever the hell those are. What's up, El Savvy Soul? Slack off on the poison gems, you'll fight with the same weapon for who knows how long. Poisonous toxicant doesn't exactly cut the mustard. Not unless you're some sort of no fun challenge gamer. Or so the Kleshas say online. Collecting 3 gems easy, but forgetting to equip them after? That's a problem. So, yeah, luckily, that's something you learn. So, you see the ones that are marked target, obviously, the ones we go after. And here's our new, this is our new Toxican right here. The Mahoro one. As you see, quite useful in its simplicity. Pinrin doesn't pose like that. She crashed the whole event, yep. She's obsessed with Pinrins. Maybe we should compare them. How about we just look at the thing that says target? Yep, we're talking about a super fan. An obsessed super fan. Like that one right there. That was close. Yep, you got it right, Izzy. This is a true weeaboo. Pinrin goes to bed by 9 p.m. sharp. Oh my god, really? I don't know, because what? Creepy! Yep, we're talking about a very anal fan. And you can get bent. Oh, jeez, H. You
jackass.
This is one of those examples of the constant deluge of enemies that come after you, because as you see, I can't do anything because they're gonna come back. True Men of Culture, watch Outlaw starring Cowboy Bebop. Yep, indeed. And we're talking about the real real Cowboy Bebop, not the Netflix one. Not the one that shouldn't exist. Ow, jackass. I gotta heal again. Alright. Where are you, Klesha? There you are. That Klesha is dead. And as you see, by getting enough of these mires, you'll notice my HP went back up to full. So, like I said, this stuff just quietly creeps up on you. And my radio gauge is full now, so now I have a soul shock attack again. First, I see a gold chest right here. That's usually a good sign. There's the third poison gem. We're good. New weapon for us. And the girl's banned from the meet and greet. I see something that needs to be re-educated. This was because of a breakup, really? It's So we've gone from psychopath to heartbreaking one to whatever the hell you want to call it. Izzy, you said right. Weeaboo. Or maybe even simp, I'm not sure. I must accept Pinrin for who he is, what? Well, this is interesting stream, guys. I'm going to stop right here because this is getting really, really creepy. What the f- I'll accept Pinrin for who he is, Guts, and... Huh? Extreme weeps! Extreme weepoo! Alert! I love Pinrin. I think she needs to be re-educated in more ways than one. Costume? It's not a costume. What? I should hope so. You had to bring a bow tie. What the hell? It ain't easy being a mascot. Just ask Jack Frost, hee-ho. Tell white poison that is a tsundere through and through. So says the one who is exactly the same type. Apologize to you on set to T. Huh? Oh, jeez. So about that set to T. So next time, as you, if you have an apology to do, you have to do it over set to T. Like you were gonna be a while, so I just left. Signed the delivery, Klesha.
Hmm.
And we got our final thing here, a catalyst, as you see. An extra bonus. This one right here will give you max HP. You can increase your defense as well. Being the first one, obviously, it'll get replaced later on. There's not really much balance in these things. So almost always, as general rule of thumb, the newer ones are the better one. Not always, but most of the time. Seven. Let's see, dear Chaco. I poured some water into Mr. Ant and his friend's house until they floated up. What? And I deaded a whole bunch of them. Great, so now we're going to take care of a hell of a kid who's on a killing spree of little creatures. But nothing happens, so I'll try a fish next time. Aha! Said it right, Kikiri. Messed up indeed. Well, if she keeps this up, she's gonna need a whole lot of set to tea to apologize over. I've got him next time, glass of thing. He's reading up but a big cloud of. Seek and destroy. I gotta admit, I really do enjoy the OST in this game. There's some pretty good tracks here. I didn't really pay attention to it a lot, but I kinda do now. It's pretty cool. So we got our first enemy here. We got dogs now. Obviously, their whole shtick is they just charge after you, but there are some that you know how to shoot weapons later on. Kinda like how the pink sort of blends in too well here. I mean, I can make it out, but this may be a case of too much pink. And as you see, we got a split right here, so we have to go all three ways. Bell memory number one. So the dog died, she didn't know what happened. Misaki listens to her screams, thus she shows up. Yep. Random mire over here. This could be a poison gem. Nope, it's not.
Oh, go that way after the fact.
Ah, look, gold chest. Beautiful. And over here, my, why are you putting Chaco in the fire? They stopped feeling anything. He included what? You're kind of seeing what happened is the girl can't come to terms with Chaco's passing. And it also seems like the mother's being kind of negligent about the whole thing, not actually having a proper talk. So. Yep. Parent of the Year material right there indeed. So you're starting to see how it's kind of multiple faults. Up door over there, that usually means go there later. So of course after all this she deludes herself, and this is why she goes on a murdering spree. Why? Because the pair, why? Because the mother is an idiot. You're starting to see right how this rapid fire doesn't do much damage at all. And that's a big reason why that Mahoka one I'm going to replace very quickly. The goldfish buried, the frog splatted, maybe a cat, or all my, oh,
oh, oh god.
That was a one shot! That fucker just one shotted me! Urf! Well, I think a quick heal is needed. Yep, kids do dumb things, but I think that's going way overboard. So Chaco's sort of telling us what to do. Right there. that heavy shot's pretty useful. As you see, it does considerably more damage than anything else I have. Must be the third, it is. Alright. Why paying attention to your kid is important. Why you pay attention to your kids, parents. Yeah, those puns, Izzy. Yeah, expect Midori to do that. Kikiri doesn't. Kikiri's definitely a lot more snarky. See, once I got your praying mantis and a butterfly, I put them together in a cage and... Psh! Yep, it seems like PETA's in hell too. Midori's wearing a face mask right now. What? Oh, not a face mask. Duct tape. So, yeah, she got revenge. She got revenge for bug spray by doing the duct tape. The second circle of hell. Anyway, watching Let's Plays Max Grinding. It's that Kakiri. Mm. Yes. You know what this means? They acknowledge the existence. Nipponichi acknowledges them. Kakiri, we love you. Couldn't stand by myself. What'd you call me? Rancid ass? Oh, transit pass. Also, yes. Yep. An Oni with a very impressive pair of horns. Nice meat. Wrong meat. Poison it. A deep blush spreads through Poison's face as her gaze fixes somewhere else. I can hear Poison's voice echo bigger than the planet in the back of my head. But I would definitely say they're probably not as big as the Earth itself, even if you put them together. A transit rest bus. But... in the universe in Beckman. But I would say they probably aren't as big as the observable contents of the space and time. Definitely not a part of that no-press prestige. Naga. So those are kind of like your area guardians, essentially. and the first couple may seem intimidating, but later on down the road, you find out they're not that hard at all. I got a new weapon too, if I wanted, Psycho Kayamas. As you see, her attributes really don't compare favorably to Poisonette even. But the 8 clip is actually a burst shot. So you get 8 bursts. Which actually makes it much better than Mahoro's. Because Mahoro's has absolutely no accuracy to speak of. So let's do it. To the second circle of hell. So these are different in the sense that you're not, you know, working on Myers in the same fashion or anything like that. It's more like a test of sorts. A black poison, yep.
この先にやめといた方がええよ。門のところにあれ、なんやくって、ヘビ、そう、なんやんとさ、えらい匂いする。ちょっと触るのやめてよ。でも小さいしたたかでずるて。 え、うち嫌われてもうた？ほな、退散し、おきに。いっちょっと、したたかで。マジ意味わかんない。そんなこと言われても、自分のことなんて先に進もう。
Here we go. Here we go. To the next level of hell. And our friend, the Hell Savvy Souls, here. No laughs, no tears. Yeah. So basically, they're kind of like just quick stages with a boss fight at the end. If you're expecting the Naga boss fights to be anything epic, they're not. Literally, they're basically dodge attacks, hit the weakness, the next thing. I might as well get Psycho as some action. As you see, it's a burst shot. And also, whenever she hits something, you saw the little paw print. Which is a cute touch. Tail dogs are the ones that can actually tag you from distance, so they're the ones I'm picking up. Hello.
Hello.
90% of the mire, huh? Okay. That should be easy enough. Yes, I'm doing this because I feel it's necessary, because I get more delirium, which is going to be useful for the boss. Those heavy shots aren't a joke. They hit hard. Come on. There you go. Here it is. So this is where your boss fight is. Now that's a Naga, as you see the weakness right there, right where the crotch is. It has a few ways it can attack you, but I would recommend the first thing to do is to take care of some of the mire nearby, just so you give yourself a little bit of free room to work with. It likes to call lightning down on you, so that's probably the main thing you gotta worry about. But it'll also have that. As you see, it hurts. Oh, there it is. That's the attack right there. And the eggs summon enemies. Pretty self-explanatory, as you see. Ow, fuck me. I did get stunned, though. Ooh, that was close. on. I just need to get myself a little bit of healing. Yes, Izzy. Yes, it is. And there you go, down. So that's the first knockout. Later ones will have multiple heads and stuff like that, so you expect to get harder, but like I said, when you have better firepower, it becomes an afterthought. And with that, I think this is a good place to stop the stream for the night, so we'll take care of the second circle next stream. Thanks for watching, everybody. I will see you later.